Why current affairs? Because if you are able to understand the psyche behind whatever is happening in the society, you are. Hello everyone, today we'll be talking about how to score high in psychology optional. Since the subject is very fancy and it is a very soft subject and we have very less of resources in the market, so today we'll be discussing about what are the do's and don'ts that we need to follow so as to score high in this optional. So let's begin. Before I start, first thing that we need to know is that whenever you are opting for this optional, even though you're not having any background for the subject, but what you need to know is that you should have a very keen interest for this optional. That means, first thing, whichever optional you are following, even though you are not having any background on that subject, but you should have a very strong interest. You should have a curiosity for that subject. And once you have that curiosity for the subject, the next thing that you need to do is that you have to build your foundation for this subject. All in all, what you need to focus on is that the foundation of the subject should be so strong that you are able to understand what is demanded from you from the question. So make your foundation very strong for the subject. That is, you have to focus on the theories. Focus on the prominent psychologists. Now, this shall help you in interlinking. I will talk about interlinking in my another slide. But before that, what you need to focus on is that there should be a very strong foundation. Why? Because if you are able to inculcate the interest and the curiosity for the subject, this shall become easy for you. So after this, what you need to do is now resources. See, when you start preparing for this optional, what you'll find is that resources are very limited in the market. Why? Because not much people are interested in exploring the psychology of the mind. Why? Because in India, still we don't consider mental health as serious as it is. Hence, the market for the resources is very limited. Now, in order to score high in this optional, what you need to do is that you need to have good material. Now, where will you get this material? Now, this is done through extensive reading. If you have joined any of the institutes, no matter what, whatsoever, what you need to do is that these people will provide you what? Resources. Resources of each topic. So that way, what is going to happen is that you are going to have what? Material for each topic. Now, since you have material for each topic, the next thing is your mocks. Your test series. Now, why test series and mocks are important? Because practice, practice, practice. And practice makes the man perfect. Now, after practicing the test series and the mocks, what you need to do is evaluation. Now, for that, you need to have a good evaluator. Why? Because the person who has written the examination, the person who has faced the examination, the person who has read the subject can help you better. Why? Because UPSC has never said that, they want some PhD scholar for this subject or for that matter, for any subject. What you need to do is that you need to cover the syllabus that UPSC has provided you. And for that, you require a person who has already faced that examination. So that person can evaluate your sheets and tell you where you are making mistakes. So for that matter, you should have a good guidance. So what you need to do is that first build the foundation, then go for the material, then go for the test series, and all this is one side. Other thing what you need to do is that you need to have a good guidance. Fine. After this, what you need to do is paper. Now see, we are having two papers. One is paper 1, one is paper 2. Paper 1 is more of static portion. So here, whatever theories you have read, you will be talking about these theories. You will be talking about various psychologists. For example, one such theory is Carl Rogers' theory of self-actualization. Other theory, for example, is of Skinner, that talks about behaviorism. Likewise, we have multiple theory for psychology. So what you need to do is that paper one, you have to have a very good knowledge about these theories. So that will help you in building your scores for paper one. Now coming back to paper two, this is very dynamic. So for this, you require what? A good hold of paper one. That means you are able to implement and integrate the paper one with paper two. So here I will talk about interlinking. Now interlinking is done how? When paper one is related to paper two, and also if you are able to inculcate the examples of current affairs. Right? Why current affairs? Because if you are able to understand the psyche behind whatever is happening in the society, you are easily able to decode where the nation is going to run or where the society will actually land up. For example, we are right now facing what? This big fat Indian weddings. So if you are able to relate this, then you can definitely talk about one thing that is going to be prominent with you know, this generation and maybe other generations that are going to come, that is materialism. That means now here you can relate was Maslow's hierarchy of need. So this is how you have to attempt the paper. That means you have to be very thorough with your theories for paper one. Then coming for paper two, you have to you know, link paper one with paper two completely. Why? Because that's a very, very dynamic paper. Now further revision. See, since the syllabus is humongous and no one resource need to be preferred, that means you will be having topics from you know, multiple resources. You will be making notes for that. So one thing you need to focus is on revision, and revision is only possible if you are having short, concise notes. And these short, concise notes could be either you know, in PDF forms, or they could be your handwritten notes. But your notes are very important. Why? Because by the time you are writing the paper, the only thing that you are able to revise is your notes. Why? Because you have actually made it. So here you should have all the key concepts and all the key theories jotted down in a very you know, concise manner. So short, concise notes, very important for your revision. So this is how you are going to maximize your score for psychology optional. The main part is that you should have the very much interest for this subject. if you're not having the interest for your subject, then it would become very difficult for you to carry the journey. Why? Because you have to cover the subject in 5 to 6 months. So thank you so much.